In this example, we are required to calculate the period of small oscillations of a floating box as shown in figure. If it is slightly pushed down and released, we are also given that mass of box is m and its base area is a and the density of liquid is rho. In this situation, as we can see that the block is submerged in the liquid by a distance h in its equilibrium position. So, we can state at equilibrium position, net forces acting on it is 0. So, its weight is exactly balanced by buoyancy. So, its weight mg will be exactly balanced by buoyant force, which is the weight of liquid displaced. So, as its base area is A and height is h, the total submerged volume of the box will be ah. So, we can write the buoyancy force to be ah rho g. Here g gets cancelled out and we are getting the mass of block as ah rho. And say this are equation 1 at equilibrium. And say now it is pushed down by a distance x. If it is pushed down by a distance x, the total submerged volume will be a into x plus h. So, buoyancy force will increase. So, we can say after pushing the block by x, if its upward acceleration is a, on releasing, this implies we will be having a relation that upward force will be a times h plus x rho g minus mg is equals to ma. That will be the equation of motion for the block. And if we just open these terms, it will be a h rho g plus a x rho g minus mg is equals to ma. Here a h rho g and mg gets cancelled out by equation 1. Here acceleration we are getting as a rho g upon m into x. Here we can apply a negative sign because acceleration is restoring in nature. And we can write for SHM acceleration is minus omega square x. If x is the displacement from mean position, comparing the two will get the angular frequency of oscillation as root of a rho g by m. Hence, time period of oscillation is 2 pi by omega, which can be written as 2 pi root of m upon a rho g. That will be the answer to this problem.